Welcome to Gypsy Jazz Quick Tips, the show in which I give you one tip and answer one question. I'm your host Christian van Hemert, and in today's episode I discuss an important concept in soloing and answer a question about learning new songs. But first, I want to remind you that I'll be in the UK and the US next month for several workshops and performances. It'll be your chance to ask any question you might have and get immediate answers and hear the ins and outs on my guitar improvisation system. If you want to know more about that, check this link. I hope to see many of you there. And now let's get started with the episode. Today's topic is something I like to call coherency, which means that you are capable of playing a solo which makes sense from beginning to end. Everybody can play a Stoller Rosenberg, a Django or a Sebastian Zeniolik, but actually building a coherent solo without sounding like you're stringing together random licks is very difficult. I want to share with you several strategies to achieve this. The basic idea is to ignore the chord changes and instead play more general lines on top of the chords that make use of creating tension and resolving to the one chord. Now, if you're not used to this, this may sound pretty weird, but let me explain it to you. It is good to realize that the 2, the 5 and the 1 chords are closely related and that 95% of the time you are actually playing on one of those chords. Now, these progressions can be greatly simplified, and I'm going to demonstrate that by playing 2 A's of Coquette, and instead of following all the chord changes, I'm just going to play on the 1 chord, on D, even though the rhythm guitar and the bass are just following the regular progression. Because I didn't have to follow the exact chord progression, I was able to focus all my attention to playing nice, long, melodic lines, instead of trying to find phrases that would fit one of the 3 chords and ways to tie them together. For the next example, I'm going to play lines on both the 1 and the 2 chords, D and E minor, but the lines I play on E minor might not necessarily be at the same time that the rhythm guitar is playing E minor. I'm just using that sound to create tension to resolve back to the 1 chord. For the third example, I'm going to play phrases on the 1 and the 5 chord, so D and A7. And again, I can play these phrases anywhere. They don't have to match the rhythm guitar at all, as long as all the phrases I play on A7 resolve back to the 1 chord. Let's go one step further and not even use the 2 or the 5 chord. In the next example, I'm going to play lines on the 1 chord and D diminished, which is not even in the progression. I just know that lines played on D diminished resolve nicely back to the 1 chord, which is exactly the point. I'm trying to create tension that resolves back to the 1. So D and D diminished. For the final example, again, I'm ignoring all the chords and just play blues lines in D, which, as you will hear, works great on 2-5-1 type progressions. Of course, you can imagine that if you mix all these strategies, you can come up with even more interesting creative lines. Now, the purpose of all of this is to show you that it's not necessary to be a slave to the chord progression, but instead try to break free and play lines that create tension and want to resolve to the one chord. Now, in Gypsy Jazz and jazz in general, there can be several one chords in one song because of modulations. So, for instance, the bridge of Coquette is in G, so then the one chord would be a G chord. What is a good way to learn new songs? That is a very good question, and I have refined the way I approach learning new songs over the years. So this is the way I do it now. First thing is, I find a good recording of the song and listen to it a bunch of times while singing along with the theme. Once I know the theme by heart, I pick up the guitar and start learning the chords, usually by playing along with the recording, and I try to memorize the chords as fast as possible. And of course, this will go faster and faster the more you do it. After I know the chords and can sing the theme, I learn the theme on the guitar as simple as possible. And after that, I'm free to add embellishments to the theme and actually start improvising on the chords. I often hear that people find it challenging to memorize chord progressions, but that is probably because they are trying to memorize each chord separately instead of looking at the bigger picture. If you want to know more about that, I made a video about it. Check it out right here. That concludes this episode of Gypsy Jazz Quick Tips. If you haven't done so already, check out the other episodes. And if you like these videos, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. That really helps me out. And if you have a question for me to answer in a future episode, connect to me on Twitter, Facebook, or in the comments section of YouTube. See you all next time.